Welcome to County Fair on Waycross Community Media. On this program, we keep you in touch with what's going on in the Hamilton County government. And today, we have with us a special guest. We have Stephanie Summerow Dumas, and she is our newest county commissioner. Thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you for inviting me.
I'm so glad that you're here, because one of the things that I want to talk about is the fact that there is history with your election.
Absolutely.
So tell me exactly what that is.
Well, I actually ran in 2006 for county commissioner, and I did not win the race, but I kept the dream alive. And then 12 years later, I was elected with overwhelming numbers as the first African American ever to be on the Hamilton County Commission in 223 years. And then the first African American woman in the state of Ohio to ever be a commissioner.
That is amazing to me, that in 223 years,
yes.
See what happens when I write my notes wrong. We have not had an African American woman in Hamilton County, or an African American woman in the state of Ohio.
Correct.
On any of the county commissions.
Yes.
And I'm really excited to get to talk about it as we look into, I mean, honestly, I think any time of the year this is exciting to talk about. But we're looking at Black History Month, and we have definitely made history here in Hamilton County.
No doubt about it. And I'm excited that I was chosen to be the one to be the trailblazer and to lead the way, because it's very past due, as you say. And so we just bring, I represent all people, certainly. And Democrats, Republicans, white, black, young, old, all voted for me. I ended up with 173,000 votes, only about 1,000 less than the governor, who was running for the whole state. So people really believed that I was their choice, and they call me the people's choice.
And you, going into the primary, were not initially favored.
Well, it depends how you
okay.
put that.
That's terrible, right?
No, but it's okay. I was not favored, but I was favored by God. And so I make it very clear that he's ahead of my life. So, but I will say that I was not endorsed.
Okay.
And so I ran anyway, because I thought it was my time, and I thought that I had something to bring different to the county. And I won by over 7,000 votes for the primary. I won every neighborhood, every community. I was the victor. So I was very proud of that. And everyone said it was a miracle. And they said, if and when I win in November, it would be a miracle of biblical proportions. So I guess they've seen two miracles now.
And I think it's exciting, because it was a very close race.
Mm-hmm.
You started your primary without a lot of funding to do that with.
Correct.
I know there were some really creative ways you made that funding work to make sure that your signs had visibility all over the county.
Right, right. We had $456. And 450 of it went towards signs. And because we did not have a lot of signs, and that's strategic to winning a race, in my opinion, we would get up and move the signs every 2 or 3 days into different neighborhoods. And people thought we had signs everywhere, which we did, but we were just moving them.
It's the same signs in a new neighborhood every
there
few
you go.
Days.
Yes.
And I love that, because that's making that work, and it also means that the people that were working with you were that dedicated, because you wouldn't have been able to do that all by yourself.
We couldn't do it by ourselves. We had 7 people.
Wow.
So it was like, wow, 7 people, yeah. So, and for our general election in November, we actually had 5 to run the whole race with 813,000 people in the county.
Wow.
So we had, so it was a, we call them the Fantastic Faithful 5.
Yes, they earned that title.
Mm-hmm.
That's a
they
superhero
did.
Team.
Yes,
that's fantastic. Mm-hmm. What are now you came to this position though with other service things that you've done behind you. This is not your first time in public service. So there were some other things that we've seen you in.
Yes, I was vice mayor in Forest Park from 1993 to 1999, and the mayor from 1999 to 2005. And then, as I said, I ran for county commission and then moved on to the village of Lincoln Heights as a village manager for 4 years. And so, and then in between that time, before I ran again for this, I wrote 2 books. And my first book is Perpetuating the Perpetrator, which I am a survivor of domestic violence, and I wrote about that, a self-help book for people. And then I wrote The Politics of Politics and Let the Games Begin. So I'm very aware of the games that are played and the rules that people follow or don't follow. So yeah, I had a lot of experience in government.
Mm-hmm. And I like to mention that because we have Forest Park viewers, mm-hmm. and they'll say, this is a name. I've seen this name. Right. Why do I know this name? And it's right. because you have served in Forest Park, mm-hmm. and this is a community that you're familiar with. But also other communities in Hamilton County, you've been working in them, so you haven't just kind of come from somewhere and wound up in the commissioner's office.
No, I work for the government as a federal grant reviewer, so I've worked federal, state, local. And so I was told when I started running, well, you haven't run for office since 2005, and you're a little bit older. I'm actually 63 years young, and I told them, winning never gets old for me. I don't know if it does for you, but it never does for me.
Yeah. Yeah, absolutely.
Right, so.
And that means you bring in with you that experience and that background that you can bring to the table when you're working on projects.
Yes, and wisdom, as you say, experience, education, just I feel like I bring a lot of diversity of ideas, and so we all do not think alike, and so we need just a different person at the table. So, and people were saying, well, it's going to be 3 Democrats, so why should we vote for you? Well, I think people have found out I'm a different Democrat. I stand for what's right. Not that Democrats don't, but I will speak up and take a stand, even if it's Republican or Democrat. I actually had a Republican who was on the county commission, Mr. Dieters, who was only there for about 1.5 years, and then he was replaced by our current president of the board, Denise Driehaus. And I met with him when he first got on the county commission, and I went down and talked to him about the suburban area and what we need to do different, and how can I help him to find solutions. And he at that point told me, he said, well, what are you doing now? I said, I'm retired. He said, oh, no, you have too many good ideas. You need to be out there doing something. So when I see this nice Republican, Mr. Dieters, I say, you're the reason why I decided to run. And so he's, so we have a little running joke about that. So
that's really important, I mm-hmm. think, right now. We see an inability at various levels of government mm-hmm. for people to work together on projects as individuals, as members of their community, mm-hmm. and not just as parts of parties. And I think that's really important to know that you can look outside of that and communicate with people and look at what needs to be done and not worry so much if someone has a letter next to their name.
Absolutely. And when I campaigned, I said I'm going to work inside the box, which is a little different. So I'm going to see what's working. Mm-hmm. If we can kind of maneuver some things and make it work better, fine. But if not, then I'll go outside of the box and look at other creative ways to deal with issues. So.
Now, I'm going to ask you, you're wearing some fantastic jewelry today, and I want to make sure that no one misses why it's so great. These are coins on a chain, and can you tell us why you're wearing that?
Well, as we all know, the Hamilton County right now has a deficit, over $29 million deficit, and so I wear this reminiscent of the fact that we need not to forget that we have to help this budget along so we can provide the services that our people and our residents of Hamilton County need so badly. So this just, we need to collect more coins. And so that's why I wear it every now and then to remind me that that's one of my missions and that's one of my goals being on the county commission.
And I do want to mention, I don't frequently comment on my guests' jewelry, but I just this having a reason beyond mm-hmm. decoration. Mm-hmm. I think I wanted to make sure that we got a chance to mention it because I thought that was important.
And I try to live my life with purpose, and everything has a, and as you get older, I think you would know, but as you get older, you live every day with purpose, and everything should have a meaning. And so that's what I try to do, and I treat people the way I want to be treated. And so I've gotten lots of letters from the community about their concerns because I think they believe that I will listen and try to help them with their situations.
What are some of the first things you think that as a commission you guys will have to take a look at as you mm-hmm. get started?
Well, as I said earlier, the budget, of course, but transportation is a major issue. And I say transportation, the accessibility to transportation, the antiquated equipment, which will cost a little money to change that, but there are grants out there that you can look into. So really concerned about economic empowerment, and that kind of ties right into transportation. If you can't get there, you can't work. Mm-hmm. So, and then I'm also looking at contracts and bids and being inclusive of everyone who has a talent to make sure that we're doing a better job of letting the community know when opportunities are available. So those are some of my major focuses right now.
Excellent. Mm-hmm. And I know the budget is going to be a big part of there's going to be a lot of mm-hmm. working to make that come together.
Yes, yes.
Do you think there's any particular hurdles you've come over in the past that'll help you kind of go forward with some of these projects?
Well, as you were saying, my vast experience I bring to the job, but also my openness and my honesty and my what you see is what you get. And so people know that I'm going to say how I feel about things. It's not about how I feel. It's from research and reading. I love to read. I think people know what they're getting when I came into this seat. And so people liked what they saw in the parades and, you know, everything that I've done. They say, this is a person possibly we can trust. You know, politicians are hard to trust, but I think they saw the level of integrity that I brought to the seat. So,
and you talked about people sending you messages. Mm-hmm. That's something I think we forget, that when we elect people, mm-hmm. And especially at the local government level and the county government level, we can connect with you.
Yes.
We can send you emails. Your emails are posted on the county website. We can send you emails and connect
right.
and call your office and let you know what we feel about things that are going on or ideas that we have, and be part of that. And I think I want to take a moment to say, when people watch these programs and they feel like I'm a disinterested third party watching things happen, these are all things that you can become involved with. I'm introducing you to people so you feel ready to send Miss Summerow Dumas an email.
Yes.
And not feel like you haven't been introduced now. Consider this your introduction
right.
to our new county commissioner. Because I want to make sure you get to hear from them.
Yeah, we've started evening meetings the first time ever,
yeah.
other than when there's a public hearing. So the last Thursday of each month, we have an evening meeting that starts at 6:30 to accommodate those who are working during the day. So having been a client rights advocate for children for 30 plus years, I'm the advocate for those who have to work during the day and can't speak for themselves. And so I'm very proud of that.
That's excellent. And we and many of the county commissioner, the meetings are filmed. People can watch them later.
Yes.
If people can't make it to the meetings, then they have access to those also.
Right.
So you can still be in touch. And the website has so much information on it.
It does. It really does.
I find that really helpful.
Mm-hmm.
I really appreciate you coming in to talk with me. I want to ask you if there's anything else that you want to make sure you get to talk about.
No, I think that I just want our residents to continue to, as you were saying, to watch the meetings, to give their input, because we're going to start working on the 2019 budget moving forward and so into 20. And so just not to remain silent, that we need to hear your, mm-hmm. your voice and not let us just sit down there and be and that people, I don't want people to be apathetic. I want them to know that their voice counts And so I want to hear from you, good or bad. And not that I'm going to agree with everything you say, for sure, but to give your input, even on the budget or the transportation, whatever issue it may be, we need to hear from you. We're serving you. We're working for you. So I want to hear your voice.
Yeah, and I know, I don't think we can actually repeat this enough, that you are representatives of the people in the county.
Yes.
And that works best if they're in communication with you, and you're not isolated from them, and you hear from them all the time.
So, and see, that's the thing I was thinking. We handle about $241 million a year in our budget. So you don't want to just sit back and let us spend this money, save this money, get this money, whatever, without you having a voice. So, and that was one reason that pushed me toward wanting to be a part of it. Nobody knows, like, what does a county commissioner do? And we're technically, we have a power and authority over the whole county for everything that exists in the county, from the judges to the sheriffs to public works, the MSD, we don't want to bring that, everything. Yeah. And I'm aware and I'm very humble that it's a very powerful position, but people need to have a part in how that $241 million is being spent.
Actually, and that's really important that a lot of people, I think, aren't, they know, they get town government, they get state government,
right.
And I think sometimes folks aren't sure what does county government cover.
Right.
So what are some of the services or programs or things that just happen magically around us and we don't even know? That's county government.
Right, like JFS, it handles all the food stamp issue, adoption. Talbert House, who helps with opioid addiction, excuse me. The sheriff and their maintenance of the Justice Center. So infrastructure as it relates to the bridges and which bridges are we going to try to repair. So everything you can think of, like I said, once again, MSD, the FCC coming up.
Yes, yeah, and soccer so, in Cincinnati. Yeah,
exactly.
Right.
And whether or not we are going to provide parking lot areas. And so we work with the city very closely. So one of my other goals is to just try to make sure that the city and the county are working as close as they can together. It's not about who's in charge or whatever. Mm-hmm. We have to work together for all our people. So any area you can think of, the county is responsible for making sure. Now, the city owns and responsible for their own streets and things like that. But social services, every social service you can think of, we have the authority to give money toward those agencies. So if you have an agency that you've been working with that is Council on Aging, that's been doing well for you, we need to know it before we approve additional money or even any money for any of those agencies. So
I think that list, and it's not comprehensive, but just a sampling of different kinds of services that I don't think people realize these are things that I want to make sure I talk to my commissioner about.
Correct.
And these are things that are important to me. And I feel this way about supporting FCC Cincinnati soccer, or I feel this way about concerns I have about FCC. You know, there are things that we're hearing about these ideas and we're thinking about things, but not realizing the county commissioners are people that you want to talk to about that. So
and they're not realizing that they actually have the power. I mean, we have been elected and given the power, but they have the power to either support us or not support us. So I think you can't, you know, don't give your power away, you know, and stand up for what you think is important in your city and in your county.
I think I'm really glad that we found some more to cover because I feel like that was really important things that we talked about.
Great.
So we've gone from your historic election. So we've gone from the past towards these are things that we can look towards in the future. I feel like we have covered a broad range. There's no way we could cover everything.
Yeah.
But I feel like we've covered a broad range. Thank you so much for coming in.
And I'm so excited about being here because I want people to know more about the people that are deciding issues, important issues in their lives.
Absolutely. And that's one of the things that at Waycross is really important to us, to make sure that when it comes to county government and local government, that they get more than a soundbite. They get more than, you know, 5 second announcement on the evening news, that they can have the chance to hear a little more in-depth discussion and get to meet people, and then hopefully feel like, hey, that made me think of something I think I want to tell her about.
Right, right.
And I need to contact Commissioner Summerow Dumas and send her an email.
Or they can call 513-946-4400, extension 3, and they'll get my office.
Excellent. So it's they don't have to have email. That's
right.
Important.
Exactly.
That comes up at meetings sometimes.
And that's
if that's the only way people can, not everyone has access or is comfortable with that, so that is important.
And our meetings are at 138 East Court Street in the County Administration Building. If you want to come, they start at 1 o'clock on Tuesdays and Thursdays, other than the last Thursday of the month, which is at 6:30.
Yeah, and that's new. That's the accessibility to people who can't come during the day, which is nice.
There are going to be quite a bit of new things I'm trying to bring to the table. So.
All right, I'm looking forward to. We had that whole list of different things to talk about and the things that you have particular goals in, and of course the budget, which will take a lot of energy at the beginning, I'm sure.
For sure.
So thank you so much.
Thank you.
I really appreciate it.
Appreciate it.
And I want to thank you for watching County Fair. That means you are staying involved with the things that are going on in your county. Make sure that you continue to be part of the process. So when you're done watching this program, make sure you figure out how you're going to get involved and who you're going to contact with your ideas.